Now we go on to the second part of green skills. In our previous class, we had learned what are natural resources, what is conservation of natural resources, and we also learned what is a green economy, that is what are the components of a green economy, that is green transportation, green construction, conservation of resources, etc. Now in this part we are going to learn another factor or fact of green skills, which is called as sustainable development. What is sustainable development? Sustainable development is the development that satisfies the needs of the present generation without compromising the capacity for the future generation. That is guaranteeing a balanced economic growth, care for the environment and social well-being. So it means that while taking care of the current generation, the needs, the social, the economic growth, the needs, the social well-being of the current generation, we are not compromising on anything which is needed for the future generation. That is called as sustainable development. Development in a very systematic method, which is good for both the present generation as well as the future generation. Giving you an example of sustainable development, let's take an example of sustainable agriculture. In this type of sustainable agriculture, the methods of farming or the livestock is production of crops, etc., is in such a way that through crop rotation, through minimal use of pesticides, the farming methods which are undertaken in this way that the fertility of the soil, the biodiversity, the water, the adverse effects on water, soil, etc. are reduced to the minimal, so that this particular land is available for the future generation also to cultivate crops. So this is called as sustainable development or sustainable agriculture, one of the examples of sustainable development. That means that taking care of the agricultural or the food needs of the current generation, along with that seeing to it that we do not deplete the soil of its resources, so that future generation also can do farming in this land. So that is called as sustainable agriculture, and it is an example of sustainable development. Let us now understand what are the problems that we face relating to sustainable development. That means what are the factors that affect the sustainable development. Let us go by that one by one. The first important problem is about food. That is the amount of rich fertile land which is needed to grow food and crops like wheat, rice, vegetables, etc. are becoming lesser and lesser as this land is being used for other infrastructural development like construction, factories, etc. So the land that is available for growing food is becoming lesser and lesser. Also, because it is continuously, because the needs of population is ever expanding and growing, then lots of the same land is being used for cultivating the same type of crops again and again. This is causing a depletion in the quality of the land. The fertility of the land is getting spoiled. Also, the use of excessive pesticides and chemical fertilizers is also causing a lot of problems regarding the fertility of the soil and the growing more and more crops. So this, as and when the fertility of the soil will reduce, it will be becoming very difficult for the future to grow any crops on that land. The fertility completely loses, because of which you won't be able to grow more food on the same land. The next important problem is water. What we are doing is we are using the water from the lakes, ponds, rivers, etc. for all the needs like drinking and cooking and many other day-to-day activities. But at the same time, we are also dumping a lot of waste and garbage and chemicals, pesticides, etc. from the factories. Everything is dumped into this water. So what is happening is that the water is getting polluted, and this water is not available. Currently it is available, but it will not be available, or it will not be in a state where it can be used for the future. So this water pollution is also, and over several years you will not be able to, there will not be having enough water resources to for the future generation. So this is another problem that we are facing. The next important problem is about fuel. That means we are cutting down a lot of trees from the forests for fuel purposes and for construction, for many other activities. We cut down the forests, and because of this problem, there is extreme weather conditions are happening, that is floods, extreme cold, there is climate change, and this is affecting the life. So as and when we keep on cutting down forests, it becomes very difficult to maintain the soil. There is soil erosion, there is floods, which causes overall there is a bad impact on the environment and the earth. So these are the three basic problems that we face, for which we need to find a solution using sustainable development. That is the food, that is the land, the soil and the water. How can we maintain the fertility of the cleanliness or less pollution for these resources, so that it will be available for the future also, along with catering to the needs of the present generation. That is what we are going to learn under sustainable development. Yeah, so now let us learn how we can use sustainable development achieve whatever goals we have set out for, that is to conserve for the future. How do we do that? First is reduce excessive use of the resources and enhancing the resource conservation. Recycling and reuse of waste material, scientific management of renewable resources, especially our bioresources, planting more trees, green pastures between constructed concrete buildings, using more environmental friendly and biodegradable material, and using technology which is environmental friendly and based on effective use of the resources. So these are the methods which we can include in our day-to-day life, so that we can conserve the resources for the future. This is called as the sustainable development methods. At the United Nations Sustainable Development Summit in New York in September 2015, 17 sustainable goals were launched, and these were to be followed by all the nations, so that it would be helpful to our planet in the future. So this particular 17 goals, which are very very important sustainable goals, were discussed at this particular main summit in New York by the United Nations. So let us go and see what are these 17 sustainable development goals which were set by the United Nations. So let us go one by one into these sustainable goals. First one was no poverty. That means totally eradicating poverty from the world. Zero hunger, which means that wherever there is hunger in the world, it should be reduced to the zero level. That means nobody should sleep hungry. Good health and well-being for everybody. Quality education. Gender equality. Clean water and sanitation. Affordable clean energy. Decent work and economic growth for everybody. Industry, innovation and infrastructure everywhere all around the world. Reduced inequality. Sustainable cities and communities. Responsible consumer production. Climate action. The life below water has to be conserved. The life on land has to be conserved. Peace, justice and strong institutions. And last but not the least, partnership for these goals. So these were the 17 important goals of sustainable development which was enlisted for the world, which would transform the world. That is called as sustainable development goals. Some of the ways in which to help this to achieve these sustainable goals, let us go one by one into details about it. In short, we are not going to look at all the 17 of them, but which are the main ones, we'll be looking at those ways in which we can help to achieve these 17 sustainable goals. The main ones, we'll be looking at it one by one. The first goal is quality education. When the entire world is educated, then everybody understands what are the problems which are faced by the world. So quality education, an educated person will understand the problems much more better. So he will be able to help out in a much better way. So quality education or education for everybody is one of the ways in which we can achieve these goals. Next one is reducing inequality. As said, there is a lot of inequality in the world. There are a few rich people and there are lot many poor people. So when we reduce the gap between this, that inequality between the rich and the poor, and everybody is almost brought to some common level, then it helps in achieving these goals. Next is clean water and sanitation. The Swachh Bharat Mission is one example of how we are trying to achieve this goal with of complete sanitation. Similarly, providing clean drinking water in most of the drought prone areas or in African countries, all these places they don't have pure drinking water. So setting a goal of giving clean pure drinking water and the sanitation to everybody, that is another, that is one way of developing sustainable, to achieve sustainable development. Next is affordable and clean energy. Nowadays everybody is, almost all nations are trying to shift over because of climate change and all the other problems. They are trying to shift over to clean energy and affordable energy for everybody. That means lighting the homes of everybody all around the world and giving them solar energy or wind or hydel power, which is clean. Clean energy which does not cause any depletion to the resources. So this is providing this clean energy is another way of achieving this sustainable development. The next one is responsible and responsible consumption and production. That means not to use the resources to just keep on producing goods which will not be consumed. So to be very diligent in our ways of consumption, reduce, recycle, use less of resources, use keep on recycling the products which you have. So in this way we can reduce our consumption, and in when you reduce consumption you can also reduce the production, because and when you reduce production then there will be automatically less use of the resources. Next one is decent work and economic growth. So the economic growth of some countries may be very high and the others very low. That becomes a big problem. So there should be a uniform development and there should be work available, decent work and economic growth for all the countries. So the in some areas there is lesser of economic development, in some areas there is in cities. So there should be a balanced economic growth in both the cities and urban and rural areas. This is another important goal. Next one is sustainable cities and communities. So the cities that are growing, the newer cities, they should be planned in such a way that there is green construction, there is proper rainwater harvesting, the city can sustain on clean energy. So this way the new sustainable cities and communities have to be brought where people are aware of waste segregation and things like that, which is very useful for the environment and for the future. So this way new sustainable cities and communities should be developed. The life below the water also along with, so that means reduced fishing activities, trawling, all this can be reduced, or dumping waste, chemical waste and atomic waste and everything into the oceans and seas, so that it can be recycled in the land itself, so that it is not dumped into the ocean. So life below the water can be saved for the future. Also life on land also, like for example growing, stop cutting of trees, forest deforestation can be stopped, or planting more trees and looking after the animals and the biodiversity of our planet. All these are methods of sustainable development. So in this chapter of green skills we have learned about how we can preserve and conserve the earth for our future generation, what are the resources which we have, and how we can build a better future with the help of these different types of sustainable goals. I hope you have understood this chapter very well, the green skills chapter. The unit is now complete. Going on to the next two units, that is the ICT skills unit. You have to refer, we have already completed the ICT skills unit in standard 9 semester 1, and also the PDF is available. You have to refer to this PDF for your future, the notes on ICT skills. It is very simple. We have been doing it from 5th standard onwards, so you know exactly what ICT skills are about. That is, what is input devices, output devices, what is Windows, how do you work with it. All this has been covered in depth to you in semester 1 of 9th standard. So please refer to those notes as well as refer to the PDF of employability skills. You will be able to get a better idea about ICT skills. Going on to communication skills also, communication skills completely is on the English grammar and communication which you have been learning over the years. These are two very simple units which you can do by referring to the PDF. So please refer to the PDF for the remaining two units. We have with this we end our series on employability skills. We have covered green skills, we have covered the self management skills as well as entrepreneurial skills, and the other two units, that is ICT skills and communication skills, you will be doing it from the PDF. So this with this we complete the entire employability skills unit. From the next class onwards, we will be covering with cover we will be starting with our main skill subject, that is IT 402. Thank you.